SchoolFreeware's Visual Basic Express 2010 Tutorials, Tutorial 22, Adding a Menu. SpeakABCs, Part 6 of 11. To add a menu strip to your form, simply scroll down to Menus and Toolbars, select the menu strip, and drop it in. Here, I'll rename the menu strip to, say, Menu Strip Main, because it'll work with my main form. And up at the top here, we have an area where you can type menu items into your menu. So let's start off with an ampersand file and one for exit, E&xit. And the ampersand works with the Alt key, as I'll show. So here we have file and we have exit. They don't do anything at this time. But if I hit the Alt key, an underscore comes up on the F. So if I hit F on the keyboard, we get the items within the file menu, which will be exit. So I'll just hit X, close this down. For keyboard shortcuts, I'll click on exit and then go to the keyboard shortcut key. And here I'll make exit Alt F4. And I'll go ahead and double click on exit, which will go into the code, and let's say close, which will close the main form down. So go ahead, run, and here we have file. And if I click on exit, the program closes. I'll go back to the design here and add a file menu for color. So ampersand color. And here I'll have ampersand background color, ampersand font color, and I'll click on background color, and I'll set the shortcut key to Ctrl B, and I'll set the font color to Ctrl F. With the background color, I wanted to do the same thing as the background button. Same thing with font color. Font color should do the exact same thing as the font color button. So what I'll do is I'll just click on background color first, go to events, and here we have click. Click on the down arrow and select button background click. So therefore, if the background color is clicked on within the menu, it'll do the exact same thing as if you were clicking on the background button. Click on font color. Go to click, down arrow, and select button font click. I'll go ahead, run, color, background color. That works, font color. Okay, we'll try Control B and Control F for font color. Okay, that works pretty good. Close this down. And I'll go ahead to the next menu item. I'll set ampersand speak, ampersand letters. I'll change letters, Control, and then L. I could type that on the keyboard. Go straight to L. Next, I'll do ampersand all. And I'll set its shortcut key to Control A. Ampersand numbers. And its shortcut will be Control N. With letters, what I wanted to do is just simply change the radio button. So just double click on letters. And I'll say radio button. Letters.checked. Equal true. Double click on all. Radio button all. That checked. Equal true. For numbers, double click and radio button numbers that checked. Equal true. I'll go ahead and run. So we have numbers, the radio button changes, all, letters, Control A, Control N, and Control L. All works, very good. Close this down. Here I want to play the alphabet song. Put an alphabet, ampersand, song, so Alt S will work. I can't have Alt A because all is Alt A. So here with the alphabet song, I want to do the same thing as the ABC song button here. So what I'll do is just click on alphabet song, go to events, click on the down arrow and select button song.click, which will take us straight to the ABC song click area. But here I would like something a little bit different, because here we have menu items that work with the radio buttons, and this one does not. It works with this button. So here I will just right mouse click, and I'll go to insert, and I'll select the separator. And now a separator is between these group of menu items and the alphabet song. So when I go ahead and run, it's a nice separation between the two.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
I'll just close this down. And before I go to the next item, I'll just go back to properties. And I see that I forgot to put in the shortcut key. So I'll just go back to Control S for song. That's put in there. Looks pretty good. And finally, I'll end with help. So ampersand help. Ampersand view help. And ampersand about. For view help, the shortcut key will be Control F1, and about will have as Control Shift A. And I'll work with the code for help and about in a different tutorial.